So back in the 11th century is where we first see evidence of dike building. These dikes were really small, and most of them were built in the Netherlands by the Dutch and Frisian people at the time. Over many years, the people of Holland built a stable, extensive dike design across their coasts, and they were able to reclaim thousands of acres of land back from the sea. These lands were converted for agriculture and were a big success for the Netherland communities that would have otherwise been underwater. Fast forward a couple hundred years, and we arrive in Port Royal, Nova Scotia, where French settlers established themselves and began spreading out across the eastern Atlantic. After a few decades, the French settlers, known as Acadians, had begun transforming the marshlands around the Bay of Fundy by installing dike systems to reclaim the land. Prior to the dikes, the Bay of Fundy marsh had been building up through the accretion of sediments and vegetation over thousands of years, so it could keep up with sea level rise. Yes, sea level was rising back then too. It's been rising all the time, but in recent years, there's been a noticeable increase in the rate at which it's rising, which is the problem. Just like in the Netherlands, the Acadians reclaimed much of the former marshlands for agricultural use. In Nova Scotia and across the eastern Atlantic shore, provinces and states have continuously built dike systems to reclaim land from the sea. Nova Scotia dikes have been repaired and upkept year-round by raising them to accommodate rising sea levels. But there are a lot of potential problems with the dike systems that people are racing to find solutions for before coastlines are destroyed or agricultural and residential areas are flooded. There are many different ways to construct a dike, but the basic structure consists of using peat-like sod and layers of brush as a seawall barrier between the land and sea. A dredge is dug behind the dike to collect fresh water from agricultural and rain runoff. The water flows into the ocean like it normally would, but now through a sluice. This is the abotal, where water is able to flow out to sea, but the pounding pressure of the tides keeps the door to the sluice closed and seawater out. As sea levels rise, protected lands behind the dikes are threatened by storm surges. Waters could easily overtop the dikes and flood agricultural and residential areas. In a study done by St. Mary's University, researchers say 70% of the dikes in Nova Scotia are at risk if impacted by even a 1-in-50-year storm. As is the case with the Tantramar dike lands, where storm surges threaten flooding lowland areas of Lower Sackville, New Brunswick. These are not only residential areas, but the highway connecting Nova Scotia with the rest of Canada is at risk too. In coming years, if sea levels keep rising at increasing rates, dike systems won't be enough to stop Nova Scotia from becoming an island. So, sea levels are rising, and the dikes in Nova Scotia are essential in keeping floodwaters at bay. What's the problem? Raising up the dikes, which is what the provincial government has done over the years to adjust to rising sea levels, just is not a sustainable solution. It wastes money over time, and the dikes will always need repair. Seawalls like dikes also encourage the destruction of habitat that lies between the dike and the ocean. This is called coastal squeeze and is extremely detrimental to coastal ecosystems. The good news is that there are many sustainable solutions that Nova Scotia would be able to implement over the coming years. Reinforcing the dikes to make them stronger is the current plan for dike systems in Nova Scotia, and while this could be viable for a few years, even more sustainable solutions are available. Many countries have experimented and been successful in producing crops in saline conditions, so salty agriculture could be an option that not only allows the dikes to be opened up, but also reduces the freshwater input in the agriculture sector. Other solutions involve structures being built far enough from the coast and high enough to allow floodwaters in without damaging property. Imagine a raised residential building with extensive vegetation below to attenuate the force of storm surges. It's not that crazy of an idea, but the research and studies need to come first. There is a lot at play if we're talking about reshaping and converting dike lands that isn't limited to our agricultural farms. The intertidal and marshland habitats are both at risk. Future plans are coming, but a lot of Nova Scotians don't know about how the dikes have served them for years, or how their upkeep is not a sustainable option for the future.
And I drank from the sea, but it opened up and swallowed me. So I sank down deep. a seasick dream.